What is good, beautiful people? So we are coming at you with another little reminder message, a little evening reminder message on this beautiful Wednesday evening. So I hope your day went well so far. And yeah, let's hop right into it. So my little, continuing on with a little bit of some of the things that I would tell my younger self is number nine is what we're on right now. And number nine is believe in your worth. And so this reminder comes actually from a video that I recently watched this past, I think it was a couple nights ago, and I actually finished it today because I kept falling asleep when I was trying to finish it. And so it was this quote from a guy by the name of Dr. Joe Dispenza. And the video, he was actually on a podcast with Ed, a guy by the name of Ed Milet. And the video is called How Meditation Can Help You Create a New Reality for Your Life with Dr. Joe Dispenza. And so he said this little quote at the very end of the video that was undeniably the greatest shift in my entire perspective since reading a book called The Power of Now by Eckhart Tolle back in college. And now I'm actually reading that right now. And so he said, the quote that he said was at the very end of the video, it's about an hour long podcast. He says, "The universe only gives us what we think we are worthy of receiving." And so when he said that, it was, I kind of thought about it really quickly and thought, you know, I think a lot of the times what we like attract into our life or what we believe like we're capable of doing really stems from like how we kind of perceive ourselves or see ourselves and what we like think we are capable of. And I think a lot of that may stem from like our past, right? Like our past conditioning or experiences from like what, like growing up or from other people like tell us who we are. I think as we grow up, we kind of experience and discover who we are from like our own actions and stepping into risk and doing things on our own and doing things we've never done before and realizing, oh, like it's not that scary, like I can do this. And continually doing that, like learning from past mistakes and past failures and really discovering like who you are as a person. And in that, by doing that, you discover your self-worth and you start to believe in your capabilities and you believe in yourself and you develop this confidence, you develop this worth. And so I thought to myself, like, you know, what if every day like you believed that you are worthy of love? What if every day you believed you were worthy of success? What if every day you believed you were worthy of happiness, contentment, and joy? What if every day you told yourself that I feel like whatever it is that I want in my life, like if it's love, if it's success, happiness, contentment, and joy, what if every single day you told yourself that I'm worthy of this and I will attract this into my life? Because I think a lot of that stems from, and just from my past experience, my personal experience, I think we all kind of, to a different extent or levels, I can only speak for myself personally, but you know, I think as I've grown and matured, I think there's this level of like imposter syndrome in a way, like, oh, like, am I qualified to do all these things? Or am I capable of doing these things? And I kind of think it just kind of comes back to like believing that I'm not good enough to do things. And so I think, you know, if you believe you're worthy of doing things, you're capable of love, you're capable of success, you're capable of wealth, you're capable of happiness, contentment, and joy, like that will come into your life. And I think when Joe mentioned, he like said this quote, "The universe only gives us what we think we are worthy of receiving." That just like clicked, like that was this unlock in my mind that was just like, you know, that's so undeniably true. So I hope that helped and clicked with you as well. And so Joe actually has these two books that I can't wait to read after rereading The Power of Now right now. It's called, the first one is called Becoming Supernatural, and the second one is called Breaking the Habit of Being Yourself. So those are going to be the next two books for me on the docket. And yeah, that's all I got for today's little Wednesday reminder message. I hope you have the best rest of your Wednesday night, and I will see you tomorrow. Love you guys. Peace.